Now, I heard you're making some waves lately. Waves in the kiddie pool, but waves nonetheless.
Maybe, but I didn't come to WWE to be in the kiddie pool.
Didn't say that you did. Just like I didn't come to WWE to be pushed as the next big thing, only to be ultimately set aside and fired.
Why did you bring up being fired? Is this supposed to be making me feel better?
Started that way, but admittedly it took a turn. Sorry, I should have been more clear. I expected everything to be handed to me, but you're doing the work. Don't let up. Those waves you're making will be noticed.
I respect the effort, but it's gonna take a little bit more than that to get a match with me, LJ.
I've got some good news for you.
You've actually got a match for me this week?
Actually, yes.
Wow, I wasn't expecting that kind of good news. Thank you.
I should clarify. It's not on SmackDown, but at a non-televised live event. Dana Brooke was supposed to have a match, but she did one too many handsprings, sprained her wrist, and can't compete this weekend.
I'm the backup option? You could have just booked me from the start.
You're lucky to be any type of an option. Stepping in for Dana on short notice would definitely help your standing with management. Winning the match would help even more.
Then I'm in, and I intend to win.
The following is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring from Hollywood, Florida, Goddess Emma Rage. And from Staten Island, New York, the most beautiful woman in all of WWE, come.